back. Boom. Got it. Sorry. We recently had a microphone break, so I feel like I have to explain every single technical difficulty. It's not me. I swear it's the studio. We had a microphone break, so I'm not working off microphone two. So I turned on microphone one, coming back with a break, and it didn't work. Anyway, guys, game two. We saw Speed Gaming took down the legendary Miracle Naga. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Like, it looked like they weren't even trying. They were just like, it's whatever. We'll just farm up. All the farm was on the Naga Siren, and it felt like the Gold League just kept on climbing for Speed Gaming. We're going to go ahead and get into this game, however. Game two, very, very excited, though. Hopefully, Titan will be able to make sure and come back. We may have to remake here. 1437. 1437, please. Delay in the game. Oh, dear. All right. Anyway, guys, but joining me will not be alone. Yeah, Ryu got DC'd as well. But Ryuuboruz, formerly a Pretty Boy Swag. What's going on, man?
How's it going, guys? That was a pretty good game to watch.
Yeah.
I loved it.
It was a good way to watch how to properly deal with the Naga Siren.
Yeah.
I felt Speed Gaming, they made very, very few mistakes when it came to this. Demon, please.
Kind of came down to like the end picks. Like I said, they both wanted a mid hero, and one chose Rasta and one chose OD. So I think...
Yeah, that OD counter pick was just like, well, what do we do now, guys? Like, seriously.
It's like the perfect counter to Naga, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was really, really unfortunate for... Because at that point, like, they couldn't win mid, and they couldn't do anything else with mid. Like, they couldn't switch up their lanes in any way. What were they going to do? Put Bristle back there and put, like, Shadow Shaman bottom? There was just no real options for them. Oh, apparently. Red Leader standing by. Apparently, we're waiting on another person. We don't know who it is. But, hence the check. Check 1-2, 1-2. More, many capitalize. I had a good conversation with 1437 about his, what he's going to be doing in the Dota scene. He's a good guy. I like him.
Is that how you spell it? I'm not very positive.
No.
All right.
No, you failed. You failed. That U does not belong there.
Dota2.com, hold on, wait. It's going to be salvaged.
That U does not belong there. Ryuuboruz. I think your obsession with U's is clear in your name. And now it's messing up. Oh, God, now we just lost 1437 and one of the other spectators. What is happening? Frostivus, what have you done? Frostivus broke the game. What are we calling the new match now? Oh, it was Winter. Winter dropped. Oh, Winter, no. Maybe Home was in trouble. Maybe he had to go save Home. I was spamming that. Earlier when I was on the test client, I was playing the, what are we calling it now? The new mode. It's not Frostivus, but it's something different.
X-Hero Siege?
X-Hero Siege.
Yes.
Something.
X-Hero Siege with only four
defense
lanes.
Defense of the Wraith King. Dio.
Oh, yeah. Frost of Wrath. Talking about that?
Dok.
Something
like that. Anyway, while I was playing that, I kept telling my team, Home in trouble! Home in trouble! I was this Venomancer running around. If you guys haven't played it in the test client, it's a lot of fun. Definitely be sure to check out that mode when it's in the actual client. It's going to be very, very fun to play. But basically how it goes is all the heroes have these buffed up abilities. Certain abilities are really, really buffed up. For example, Venomancer, like you have all these hard carries to pick from. And then you're like, Venomancer, why are you here? And it's because he gets a regular ward and a buffed up ward that does more damage, but also can cast your level of Venomous Gale. Yeah. So I'm just running around throwing down wards everywhere, throwing gales every which way, left and right. It doesn't actually automatically cast it. So you have to actually, like, micro your way to victory.
You told me Venomancer is the best hero, so I'm going to pick that hero every Frostbust game.
Yeah, and I was
just
like...
You lied to me.
I was slowing down all the bosses.
It's great percussions.
It was easy.
No, have you got to the end? The max rounds or whatever? Or how does it work? What do you get when it ends?
Yeah, you complete and you get your crystals.
5 seconds remaining.
Save the Wraith King. Yay!
How many rounds do you have to go through?
I don't remember. Time. I do not remember. Anyway... Let's get into this game because we finally got the spectators. Everybody's in, loaded, we're up. Speed Gaming versus Titan. Game 2, Speed Gaming convincingly taken game 1, even up against the Miracle Naga, and it doesn't even look like last time DK, they couldn't deal with it, and they banned it out.
10 seconds.
Speed Gaming, I think they're just going to let it go. They're just be like, whatever, we dealt with it once, you can deal with it twice.
Remaining. Yeah, Speed Gaming's opting for a second pick too, both games. So that's pretty interesting.
Dire team
I think last game they wanted Radiant, and this time they wanted maybe Dire. I don't know. I don't know how that worked out, but I assume the same bans are going to happen. Nothing really changed that last game, unless they want to give them Potom.
5 seconds remaining.
Oh, I would love to see a Potom on either side. On either side, on Ohio or on Sing Sing. Please let that happen.
What are you talking about?
Speed Gaming. Well, Omni Knight, that was an interesting strategy to watch, and it was fun. But please, Speed Gaming, Eternal Envy, if you're the one captaining from that bottom position, if also Valve, can we have a little thing that shows us who's drafting? Anyway, thank you. Mirana, please be picked up sometime here on either team. I don't even care. Clockwork is picked up by Titan as the first pick. A little bit surprised there. Crystal Maiden, and boom, there it is. Mirana is picked up by Speed Gaming. They knew they had second pick. They didn't really value Mirana enough to first pick it last time, I guess. So they wanted to be able to have second pick in order to snag Mirana. And they grabbed the CM with it. So, and Titan, they're going to go for it again, man. We're going to see it again.
No Coddle, though. That hero is not as useful without Coddle. You need the mana on Naga Siren for her to be useful with the split pushing. And so Coddle helped a lot early game last game, especially with all the stacks he was doing.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's actually a really good point. Like, especially with the way that not only he was able to turtle out a lot of those early towers and keep them alive, but also be able to bring the Naga Siren back. Back to safety.
Reserve
back
time.
To home.
I really liked watching last game. They had like everything stacked. They had the big camp, even like next to the big camp stacked. They had their ancient stacked the whole time. I wonder if they're gonna get Bristle back. No, that's Clockwork offlane. What am I thinking?
Yeah.
Unless they do a mid. Easy.
Yeah, we'll have to see. Bans coming out though. OD and Nyx Assassin taken away by Titan. Meanwhile, keep it light. And waiting on the second ban coming out from Speed Gaming, and it is going to be the Shadow Shaman. So they're going to take away a little bit of that control, no surprise, especially since you've got a Mirana. And also, the early being able to split push with the Shadow Shaman was also kind of obnoxious. Being able to take out some of those tier 1s. Give Titan a little bit of that early gold, that early jump into the Radiance.
I don't know what they can really go here. Still, there's so much. There's still so much in the pool. You can still go. Remaining. I think.
Are you still trying to pull up
PL?
Are you still trying to pull up the hero pool? Is that the problem?
I'm trying.
Is that the pull problem?
He's
gonna
pick PL. PL versus Naga. I'm telling you, PL wins that.
Oh my goodness! Don't
do it.
No, stop asking for that. That's awful. That's an awful. Like that's being down in the sewers watching the Rat Dota fight. That's awful. Don't suggest that ever again. You're off the stream.
Ouch.
Boom, down the law. Laying down the law.
Just wanted mass illusions, guys.
No. No. Puck is picked up by Speed Gaming, so that's going to give you a little bit of your control. That's also going to give you your mid for Speed Gaming.
Now they're going aggressive with heroes. Putting Sing Sing Nibu Mirana. Puck's going top. Or 0.7.
I know you guys love seeing my lovely face, but that wasn't actually what I meant to cut to.
10 seconds.
I actually meant to cut down to the Chinese stream where they were showing the players, but.
5 seconds remaining.
I gotta get me some Sing Sing action. That's all it is. I just gotta throw it up on the stream whenever
more
I can.
Selfies.
Wind Ranger. Great. So that hero is in the game, meaning I'm gonna have to. Oh, there is our Lord and Savior, guys.
Where?
He's on stream right now. Turtle Envy, thinking long and hard about drafting.
How come I
and apparently there's some
like
joke
10
going
seconds
on.
Delayed, and then I can't see, and then I have to talk later. This is
the drafting fair. Phase. What do you mean? You can just constantly have the stream up. It's not like something's happening that you need
to
look
he's
at.
10 seconds remaining.
He's smiling at me. He's laughing at me now.
When EE Sama smiles, the
Radiant
world smiles.
Team pick.
Dream Protector. Really?
Oh, God.
Maybe that's what they're laughing at.
Please, no.
The idea of picking up a Tree and Protector. Of course, that stream is delayed, so maybe not. But still, Tree and Protector,
so
really?
Bad memories of Tree. Please, no.
Okay, so. I saw how Speed Gaming was going to deal with the Miracle Split Push in their draft last time. This time, I don't really see it as much. I mean, active
remaining.
Ganking with the puck. But the Tree and Protector, I don't really feel that follows that line of logic. I mean, it keeps the towers alive, yes, and I suppose the towers
reserve
do go down slowly enough with the split push from Nagasai, because he never fully commits to taking a tower. He just sort of slowly lets the creeps push. So I guess that'll work, right? Maybe?
Yeah, they realize that Titan has a hard time getting map control early game, so they wanna have all their towers up and putting the pressure on the map. So I kind of like Tree, but I like the Tree pick here, but I hate the hero. So
yeah,
all yep, I gotta say on that.
Same. He's got four different abilities, but you only care about one.
I'm pretty sure it's Nature Guys.
That's yep. It's definitely Nature's Guys. Please, Ice Frog. Ice Frog. I've talked about this before, but Ice
they
Frog
have, like,
has
two
to have
ulties now.
Like, he's in love with Tree and Protector. You know how many times he's reworked Tree over and over and over. And the one ability that has always seemed to stay the same is Nature's Guys. Like, he just won't get rid of it. He's convinced that it'll work. Somehow, he'll work it into competitive play. Whoops, that's not what I meant. Anyway, that's me ranting.
I didn't know that the Nature Guys gave you movement speed.
Hey, did you know you're in a boy band?
Is it with the Obi-Wan and Capitalist?
No, it's not. Get out of here. You're not in our band. No.
Almost.
You were in a boy band. It was an all. Venom. It's a five-man band, all male.
Dire
boy
team
spag.
Ban.
Sorry.
Nice.
Venomancer is picked up by Titan, so we're going to have that aggressive support to be able to lay down the law on some of these heroes.
That's the perfect counter for Tree. That's the best counter, I think, in my mind, because it ticks, and you got the massive slow.
But
we still have the issue of countering the split push with stupid heal, tower heal.
Yeah, the one thing, though, is like Venomancer just parks his butt middle and just puts like seven
Radiant
plague wards up.
Ban.
They can't really
That's
push.
True.
And you could probably, if you have like seven wards attacking the tower, I wonder if it cancels all the charges instantly.
Yeah, it should. It will. That's exactly what will happen. But, I mean, Titan
remaining.
Hasn't really gone heavy, like
heavy, yeah.
four or five Dire man push
pick.
Whenever
yeah,
they run this Naga Siren.
Yeah, they got good anti-push with Puck and Crystal Maiden, and then you always have to worry about the Sing Sing arrows that'll come in and hit you all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Because he shoots arrows and hits arrows. There's no other option.
There really isn't.
Anyway, Bane is banned out by Speed Gaming. Gonna take
Ten
that option away
remaining.
From Titan, and that's why, apparently.
Radiant team.
Told
they
you.
Wanted to go Lifestealer.
Told you they were gonna put Puck, Safelane, Bone 7, Mirana mid, Sing Sing, Trilane. I don't want to say I told you so, but I told you so.
You totally told me so. Meanwhile, Titan banned away the Weaver, and unfortunately it means they don't have that hero available to them. They could be running. Well, actually, they don't actually still have a position for him. They need their mid. If it's not Windranger, could be Windranger support, could be Venomancer mid. So
does Bone 7 play puck mid? Does anybody know this? Anybody? Insight? Insight?
Reserve time. I haven't insight. Seen him 10 play puck yeah. mid. I'm sure he does great, because he's great at everything.
5 yeah. seconds remaining. He just... It's not that hard, guys. You can do it.
Disruptor.
Anybody can do it.
Disruptor! Oh my goodness, Titan! You know how to treat a man right. My goodness, they're going to pick up the Disruptor. I can't tell you the last time I saw a Disruptor
how unbalanced
in-game.
Agnum Sector is on that
and
hero.
And Agnum's is really obnoxious and really good versus Lifestealer. But, so Speed Gaming. Crystal Maiden, Mirana, Puck, Tree and Protector, Lifestealer. That's looking like a big gank team fight. Let's go team fight lineup that is going to be able to utilize the Infest Bomb with Puck. We've got their ability to deal with the split push, and you've got a Sing Sing Mirana with those arrows. What more can you ask for? Meanwhile, Titan, a little bit of split push going on with the Naga Siren. They've got some initiation to work around with Clockwork and then the follow-up of Venomancer and Disruptor. So you've got some supports with big ultimates here.
The biggest thing here is the Naga sleep into Disruptor ulti. And if they can survive the early game, I think they have a good chance maybe for the mid game. And because they have Mirana and Puck for this mid game like aggression, but they have the counter because of Naga Siren. So if Disruptor gets hurt on his levels though, this could be a long like a really fast game though. Because yes.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
The Disruptor, like his glimpse is really amazing against Puck and Bottom. So I really do like it against those two heroes. You can't phase shift glimpse, and you can't leap away from glimpse until the very end. But by then you'll be silenced most likely or something.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's go ahead and look at the lanes here before we get any more actions. We may see it here at Bottom, but Speed Gaming. Up at top, we're going to go ahead and have the solo Eternal Envy Lifestealer. Mid, we got Bone 7.
The arrow!
Sing Sing lands it. Net, that's going to be your first blood.
That was on Sing how I died. That was really well played. He got the Nova, and that allowed the slow. So the arrow would hit. If he wasn't slowed, I'm pretty sure he wouldn't hit the arrow. So that was really nice.
Yep, well played. Going back to the lanes, though, we got Bone 7 on the Puck mid, so we'll see how he does on that. Sing Sing is going to be in your Mirana. Pylodai, Crystal Maiden, and the Trium Protector. Come back here. A-U-Y. He's going to be bottom as well. Yes. Yes, Ryu. Go
Bone
ahead.
Bone 7 middle with Puck. I don't know. I just... What is this? I don't
you're,
know.
You're so good. It's that expert insight.
But I didn't think he would, and it's against a Naga. This is like old. This is like last patch, the third last patch.
This does feel weird. Titan, they're meanwhile going to be running a net, going to be on the Disruptor. Extinct is going to be on your Windranger, and KYXY is going to be your Venomancer bottom. Miracle is going to be the Naga Siren mid, because they don't want him to have to deal with the aggro tri-lane. And they're going to be running Ohio's Clockwork up against the Lifestealer. So, Ryu, that's why I pay you the big bucks. Tell me.
Money.
Who's winning what lanes here?
Well, you have tree armor, so basically mid lane and top lane should go really well for the Speed Gaming lineup, but he doesn't have the tree armor yet. That's why they're trying to let him get it right now, I think. Because they got Leech Seed because they wanted to get that early first blood.
Right.
Just in case. So they're trying to get him there. And then mid lane, it's kind of a wash. Naga does really well against Puck. Hold on, doorbell.
Jesus, you got early morning visitors, man. My goodness. People, don't worry. Calm down, everybody. Everybody, calm down. I know you're dying to see who was winning that first wave of CS. So there it is. Last hits up. 3-0 right now in middle. But bottom, we got to keep an eye on this, especially with those Sing Sing arrows. You got Crystal Maiden on the side to slow down the heroes to make sure that they hit said arrows. Meanwhile, KYXY, he's going to be your farmer in lane, which is interesting to see a Venomancer not necessarily in the mid position as a core, but actually in the one position. That doesn't mean he's actually the one. He's not going to be your carry, but he is going to be the farmer in this dry lane. And with this, I mean, it kind of makes up for the fact that Disruptor is not a strong laning support. He really isn't. His recent upgrade in damage with Thunderstrike helps some of his harassment. But for the most part, he's more of a mid-game support. You want those maxed out levels in air, in Glimpse. Really, really effective mid-game. And then, of course, obviously, Static Storm. Your hero is non-existent until you have that Radiant first arrow. Second arrow, excuse attack. Me. Sing Sing actually misses. Pilot Die actually taking a lot of harassment here between the Thunderstrike plus Extinct. Throwing down some of those auto attacks. Meanwhile, Ohio has actually successfully burned all of Lifestealer's mana here. And he can get pretty aggressive now. Lifestealer actually has quite a bit of regen, though, that was pulled him. Either way, CS War 9-5 compared to 6-2. Oh, no, I missed it. Venomancer gets picked off. Arrow did hit. And they quickly bursted him down. I was just going back to the lane. Why? Why?
It's probably because I was gone.
Probably. Probably. I looked away for half a second. And all of a sudden, they landed an arrow, and the hero was, like, instantly dead. Because Venomancer has no health.
Oh, no.
Venomancer has no health, and that's why. He gets hit by an arrow, he's dead. Yeah. Anyway, apparently we have to keep our eye on middle constantly. Miracle should have a pretty good time, though, middle, because that Riptide, it did get nerfed a little bit. So that range, not quite as big, but still. He should be able to harass Bone 7 quite a bit with that Riptide. And he seems to have, at the very least, he's got a little bit of rune control. He picked up the first rune, which illusions, refilling his bottle. As long as he can continually bottle crow, he should do all right. KYXY again hit by the arrow, and that's going to be your second kill in this bottom lane. Third kill, actually. Extinct, maybe going to go down, has to win Runaway. And unfortunately, just again, the support Disruptor, not able to do a whole lot. Windranger's putting down some okay damage, but it isn't the greatest. And same goes with Venomancer. The damage over time just really is not that helpful, especially when you only got one level of Venomous Gale, and it's doing zero damage over time and just the 25 strike damage. Really unfortunate. They just cannot compete this tri lane when it comes to damage, even with the tree in lane. The tree actually went for the second level of Leech Seed. That's actually decent damage. Uh-oh. Extinct, he's in some trouble. They're early level in boots, and they're going to be able to pick up yet another kill. Sing Sing throws the arrow, but I'm not even sure if it was entirely necessary. Could have been thrown on Net. Net is now in trouble. Sing Sing trying to get around AUI's big fat body. Get out of the way, bro. Net.
Get it.
Going to be able to get away just in time. Nighttime helped them out a little bit there as well. But still, 0-4. This tri lane is just getting dumpster on.
And he's just harassing him.
Yeah.
He's not 6 yet.
He went ahead and popped his magic stick and then got aggressive. Ohio was doing a good job of burning his mana. That's what I was looking at, and I missed first blood, so let's not talk about that. Just forget about it. So
he got burned again.
Good point.
Yeah, Clockwork is TP'd out. So yeah. Like I said, the mid lane though, it should be a wash. Naga does really well against Puck.
Squishy ranged heroes in general. Yeah. Just he takes like the harassment, he's got 8 armor. Riptide has a huge range.
This used to be the counter back 2 patches ago. Bottom lane, they're diving again.
That's true. I didn't miss first.
So ballsy.
Oh, another arrow. KYXY. He's going to fall here, followed up for a Frostbite. They may catch AUI here, but he's just so damn tanky. Even if he does go down, look at him. He's still got 7 magic stick charges. Net's going to fall. Sing Sing. Oh, goes the wrong way. And he may not actually be able to pick this one up. Net finds himself a cozy little corner to hide in. Arrow lands on Extinct, but Sing Sing's still in trouble. He gets 1-0 on attack. He's going to try and surge him. Net. Gonna be able to. Oh, there goes the ward. Extinct now's in trouble. Bone 7 gonna be able to clean this one up. Waiting for the wind run to fall. Sing Sing does fall in the end, but they're gonna pick up a ton of kills because of this. KYXY, he's the next on the block. AUI, gonna see if he can smash him one more hit. Bone 7, somebody's gonna get it. There we go. So 1-8, Speed Gaming are off to a gigantic start. Look at that. 2,500 gold lead at 5 minutes. My god. It's tri lane.
Yeah, you don't. This is why you don't pick Disruptor sometimes, but it could also have been the fact that they got the first blood pretty early before even the lane started.
Yeah. So, it's also true.
That helps tremendously, because then you start off. He started off with the Basilius on the bottom. That gives mana regen plus. It's a lot easier to last hit.
Yeah, a decent amount of damage, too. Yeah.
So.
Issues, issues, issues. As we got a bit of a pause here, 6 minutes in. And,
Kind of expected this to happen. All right, I'm back for good, guys. I just had, like, a...
Sure, phone calls.
Stuff. But,
Doorbells.
like I thought, it would have come down to this, because they should have lost the tri-lane because they have a disruptor, and even though you have a Vino that could help, it's still not enough to stop the dives when you have a tree and a CM with a Potum. So I expected it to go like this, but not as bad. But I knew that they could come back because they had the Naga sleep with the disruptor. But he's only, like, they have Naga, and then they have the Clockwork TP, TPs with Hook to help the team. So maybe they can still get back in this, though. But
Sing Sing, excuse me, Sing Sing. Speed Gaming, they got to get in there. They're at least once a match. Washroom pause. That's what I'm going to call it from now on. Whenever Speed Gaming ever pause, this time it's because of technical issues. Apparently AUI is lagging pretty badly. But I'm just call it washroom pauses. That's really what it is. Let's go ahead and go back to the Chinese stream where we're going to see this onslaught of a team fight. Where Sing Sing, oh man, if he just went the right direction, he would have caught net. And he probably would not have gone down, but still, it was a really good team fight. Puck rotated over at just the right time. And again, I'm having issues with this Chinese stream. It always goes down at the wrong time. Frustrating.
I know.
Oh, you're friends with Joik, aren't you?
With who?
Joik.
Yeah.
He just sent me a message.
Shout out to the Joikernauts.
Joikernauts. I rang for them a couple times. And then I became a professional caster. 2,000 experience lead, and finally AWANs back in the game. Oh, and finally, Chinese stream came back.
All right, I'm going to predict a haste rune spawning top for Clockwork. And he's going to...
just pushing it.
He's going to kill somebody.
Like, predicting lanes and that sort of thing, yes. Predicting runes, really.
Really, right? He's going to get a haste rune. He's going to go top and kill Eternal Enemy. Actually, yeah, because he already used Infest.
Mm-hmm. He reconnected, but apparently they're still testing the lag or something's going on.
They're trying to say, all right, guys, let's start over. We're not...
What, 8-1 okay. Wasn't a big enough lead? Kill. They need to see if they can get a remake in?
No, it's like, we got one kill. We're doing fine, guys.
Oh, somebody in chat just reminded me. Thank goodness. Thank goodness Visage isn't in this game.
Yeah, I got banned out this time by Speed Gaming.
Yeah. What got banned out, Ryu?
Visage at the beginning.
Visage. My gosh. Hey, you could say visage or visage. Visage, really?
I realize that there's an I in there, but
we're back.
Not from America. I'm just kidding, I'm from America, guys.
Yeah, I know you're from America. Goddamn Texan.
Help, choking on air.
Well, I will call an ambulance for you, but it's probably going to be a little late. Middle bottle crowing.
Who got the rune? What happened? I didn't see it. Oh, double damage. Bottom lane. Puck guy.
Yep. He's going to have a fun time with that next time his ultimate is up. He may even have enough damage to finally kill Miracle mid. The only good thing for Titan right now is Miracle having a good time. Like, eventually Clockwork was going to lose his lane. He's actually going to rotate to bottom. Looking for that hook shot. Just picked up level 6 too. This is good timing. Unfortunately, unless they have a Shackle Shot, and even that's not really long enough.
Yeah, their supports are really well positioned. The lane's even pushed, too, so it's actually a really bad TP in my mind. Because you don't want to TP when the lane's pushed already all the way to their tower.
And Eternal Envy's pushing it at top. Yeah. He knows this Clockwork is missing. They would have to hit the hook shot into a Shackle Shot, and it's still... probably wouldn't be enough. Maybe a glimpse somewhere in there as well. We forget about
disruptor. He doesn't have glimpse.
Useless, but
He doesn't have anything in glimpse yet.
Yeah.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yep. Looks like Miracle. He's gonna try and get a little bit of rune control, maybe, and also fight some neutrals. Either way,
that's the only that's the only place where Clockwork can even TP though, unless he hooks on Puck when he illusion orbs.
That's true. He can't really gank mid at all, so
It was kind of like Radiant's a desperate level 6. All right, guys, I gotta try to make something happen for you, but... See. The Clockwork's mid, though.
You he know what they could do? I mean, they could kill Puck. He jumps in, walks forward, cogs Puck back, and when the orb goes out, Miracle sleeps.
Yeah.
Undo the sleep.
Invisibility.
And snare. Riptide. Kill. No problem. See, look, I got it all under control. Pilot Eye picks up an Invis rune. He's actually going to rotate her in the middle. And that double damage rune is up right now, and they've got the ultimate. And this may be a kill on Miracle. The
top
silence
lane.
Is 1.5
top
seconds.
Lane. Envy's going to get a kill on Clockwork.
Oh, is he? Oh, no, barely not enough. The Infest unable to secure it. Meanwhile, Pilot Eye still Radiant's looking for it, but Miracle knew. He knew attack. Something was up. Playing very, very far back.
And Poison Orb is so annoying to play against.
Here I am!
Orb of Venom, I mean.
Yeah, I don't know why. An early pickup of that on some heroes is just extremely obnoxious.
Yeah.
I don't understand why more people don't get it. Even on like some supports. Have you ever played against a Venomancer, level 1 Poison Sting, level 1 Orb of Venom?
Yeah.
Stupid.
Do you even move?
15% slow at level 1 on every auto attack. Oh my
Radiant's
god.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
But yeah, Speed Gaming, they're pretty much winning every single lane. The only upside is Titan is getting free farm on Miracle mid. But again, Naga Siren can't rotate out of middle and go gank a lane. He's just there for the farm. So these other lanes are just going to continually suffer, and Speed Gaming's just going to get more and more of an speed and experience lead. A golden experience lead, excuse me.
Yeah, they're just hoping for levels, praying for levels on bottom lane. So that's all they can do right now. Meanwhile, the other, like, I wonder how next. I'm trying to look at the late game here against the Naga.
Haste.
They should still be fine. Sing Sing's gonna go. Majoner, easy.
Yeah, double Majoner. A tier 1 tower practically down. Cog's thrown out. Eternal Envy, he still has his Infest up as well. If he can just get Ohio low enough. Ohio, the battery cell beginning to do a little bit of work. Tower's not quite deniable. And Eternal Envy just going to force the Clockwork back. Infest creep, pop out, and he's going to be full health once again.
Yeah, they're just waiting on Bone 7 to get his Blink Dagger, and then they're going to go around the map. Just controlling it. Envy's almost got top tower down. That's a lot of control to the map then too. So they'll just do Nyx bombs pretty soon here. And he should have it. Point 7 should have. Yeah, he's gonna have his Blink Dagger now.
Yeah, that's gonna be unfortunate, especially for this bottom lane. I mean, that's the first. Oh, the arrow. Unfortunately hitting a melee creep. But again, it just one rotation from Puck bottom. You're pretty much guaranteed to kill all three of these heroes.
Is he gonna go Midas? He sold his Blink Dagger.
Oh, okay. No. We're good. I was like, what?
So he sold it. Okay, so yeah. He sold it so he could buy it at the secret shop, and then he sent it because the courier sent out the Midas to Envy.
Oh, okay.
So that's pretty good.
Yeah, we got Midas up on Eternal Envy, Midas up on Sing Sing as well. And again, it's just Speed Gaming just slowly but surely out farming Titan because of this rotation. Actually, Pilot Eye trying to get close enough. Unfortunately, the slow, unable to land. Ohio is able to get away. Bone 7 going to make his first rotation over with the Blink Dagger, and he's actually going to try and pick off Ohio here, which I was expecting bottom just because it was so many easy kills out of there.
Yeah, if they get this though, they get at least half the half damage on the tier 2 tower, which is pretty good too. Mm-hmm. And all that farm is going to be wasted, so it's actually kind of good to go there. But he knows that even if he joins coils, the Clockwork's just going to cog, so it's good that he didn't go in there.
Yeah, Pilot Eye probably going to do a little bit of a jungling while he's here. Maybe stack up camp. In fact, you've already got a hard camp a little bit stacked right now. Disruptor, gotta find some levels, buddy. He's sitting at level 4 with only one level in Glimpse right now. This is rather unfortunate. This is the hardest thing about Disruptor, is always being able to find levels on him, just because he's so useless as a ganker, and a laning support early on. He just does not provide nearly as much as so many other supports. Turn top lane be a little bit low here. Ohio still had his hook shot to go, but unfortunately, yeah. Infest was up for Eternal Envy.
Midas should be coming out on CM, and I'm gonna say at the 15:30 mark, maybe.
No, oh, jeez. Midas gaming left and right.
Yeah, we didn't even talk about Sing Sing's Midas.
I mentioned it.
I don't know where I've been. I've just been watching top lane and middle lane. I haven't even been watching bottom lane at all. I'm just like, there's nothing going to happen there. Just Vino Blancer and wards.
Yeah, this is a game that is not nearly... I mean, we saw all that action bottom, but it was all so one-sided and so, like, casual.
It's because Titan can't do anything. They can't. They can't go anywhere.
It's just not the same as last game. Still, though, at least they have the Miracle. Miracle Naga to come back.
I wish this Disruptor didn't max Thunderstrike. You need two in Glimpse. You need two Glimpse, for sure. I would just left two in Thunderstrike. 1,000 range is it's a pretty big deal compared to 600.
By the way, shout out to Nahaz. Hopefully he'll be able to join us next game. But right now he's in the chat and giving some of those lovely stats that he always does. And he says this is the second time that Singh has picked up Midas on Mirana. Which, no surprise. I mean, it's a decent item if you're able to get it up early enough. But for the most part, there's just usually
I think Bone 7 should have just went Midas.
Yeah,
instead of Blink Dagger.
Yeah, just
he's just gonna go back for it now.
Yeah, he's not moving around. Just sit in lane. Midas thinks no problem.
Come on, pal, I die. Farm faster.
Net. I really thought Bone 7 was gonna like finally spy out Net, who's been sitting there for so long, just sapping experience.
All right, this Clockwork can actually die now. Because now that Eternal Envy has a armlet.
Armlet jumps in. They're actually going to go for it. Unfortunately, Sing Sing actually just picked up the Wind Ranger. Sing Sing has the armor, so he should be just fine. But I was actually busy focused on this puck.
Me too.
They're going to go for the Nature Bomb there.
Disruptor. Oh, nope.
They were actually looking for Miracle. They knew exactly what he was up to. He's been doing a little bit of stacking with his illusions at times. And Net, I don't know how.
They know, because they have that ward there. They saw him pick up a Invis rune, so that's why they're putting these sentries down everywhere. So that's pretty good play, but this Vino's dead.
Yeah, Vino's going to get picked off. They finally did find somebody in the jungle. Meanwhile, can they go on something? AY, he's going to get picked off here. They still have a glimpse to be able to throw back. Maybe Static Storm is going to be necessary. There goes Clockwork. Ohio jumping in. Bone 7. He doesn't have anything to leap to, and now he's going to go down. There goes the silence, and he is wiped out. Sing Sing throws the arrow completely whiffed. All of Titan being able to dodge it. Net. Oh, actually, that auto attack damage by itself was able to finish him off. Pilot guy, he's going to trade his life for it.
I just secured.
There it is. Eternal Envy going forward. Has his armlet, so he's going to be just fine, even if he is unable to pick up a kill. And you said Midas was secured. My God. Crystal Maiden Midas, 16 and a half minutes in. But finally, Titan does make a little bit of action happen. 4-11, 16 and a half minutes in. Gold lead sitting about, oh my goodness, almost a 10,000 gold lead for Speed Gaming. Team fight bumped it back up a little bit. Same goes the experience, about 5,000 gold lead, or experience lead right now.
Yeah, because they took that fight mid, that means that the Puck and the Puck, Nyx, and Mirana, they didn't push down Radiant bottom tower because the Venomancer got picked off, so that's pretty good. That keeps that up for a longer time, which they really need. So that was really good.
Oh, Cockflip. Eternal Envy caught out. Ohio, you got to get out of here, buddy. That arm tear him apart. Barely trying to get away. Shackle shot, very nicely done by Extinct. Eternal Envy going to jump inside the creeps, jump out, and run away. There goes the slow, though. KYXY is on the other side, and this is going to be a very, very dead Eternal Envy. Maybe not. AUY, he's coming in. If he can just get the Leech Seed off, teleport away. No, he cancels it. He knows he can finish this off. There goes the Leech Seed, and it's going to heal Eternal Envy back up. Nom, nom, nom. I really thought they were going to be able to kill him. They just have no damage. No damage whatsoever.
I think Eternal Envy misclicked. I think he wanted his magic wand or something. I don't think he wanted to TP out.
Yeah.
But
possibly. Still going to be a tier 1 tower that goes down.
Radiance bottom
even
tower
more of a gold
fallen
lead. They're going to see if they can pick off the crystal main here at top as a teleport in from clockwork goes up. No hookshot, though.
Midas on tree. All right, that's five Midas. No, four Midases. I'm telling you, where's Pop?
Bone seven's letting
everybody down, but he's going Dagon 5, so I'll give it to him. He wins.
Really? Really? Oh my god. That puck's just
Radiance
gonna be popping heroes left and right. You had a tri lane of all supports. I mean, Venomancer was the farmer, but he's as squishy as a support. Clockwork doesn't have a whole lot of health to speak of right now because he went for an early Dire's four staff versus Lifestealer, and that's obvious.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
It's a good pickup versus Lifestealer, but still leaves him very susceptible. Radiant's the nukes and Naga Sirens, the one hero that possibly could live through that whole entire combo.
Wow. That was best. I saw that.
Well, I didn't. Shadow. They picked him up. Meanwhile, there it is. Finally, I was going to see it. Ohio jumps in. They're going to get caught out here. There goes the sleep, though, from Miracle, and they're going to be able to get themselves out. Good teleports in from Speed Gaming, and they get themselves a single kill on the Windranger at middle.
They still want this. They have Puck still coming on the back. He should be able to kill this. Disruptor.
Yeah, that's going to fall. Another auto Arrow. Attack. Arrow. No, Ohio sees it coming. He's going to be able to dodge it. Just stomp, stomp, stomp. Feels like. And it seems to be no end in sight. Miracle very, very, very far away from his radiance, it seems. No, why? Oh, my God. He's already got the relic. Okay. He's not that far. I thought he had some sort of small item maybe coming to him, but he's actually already got the relic. So 1,000 gold away from his radiance.
Huh. Yeah, they still have a chance, but I don't think they can take a tower.
I'm going to blame it on me being sick. I am, like, off my game right now.
It's okay. You never had. I'm just kidding. Oh, I'm not gonna say that. I didn't say.
No, you can say that, it. You can say that, it because last that. Time I made that MLG comment at the end of the broadcast. It's okay.
It's okay.
It's out of love. It's out of love. And
so
hate.
So much stuff.
And hate because I had to cast you guys.
This arrow, calling it. Calling
yeah,
it.
Yeah, I know. Oh. He like tried to position himself to throw an arrow from the trees.
You're just like, I want to farm that ward instead. No? Yeah.
Desto is now picked up on Lifestealer, so he's going to be able to burst anybody he throws open wounds on.
Alright, we should predict how long Roshan lives. I'm going to say 7. No. 7? No. 8 seconds.
Oh my goodness. Well, I'm going to say 7 seconds. Fuck you.
No,
oh, okay, well, he's solo. He's solo.
Himself.
That's right, that's right. No, that's
this is like
all bets are off because he's soloing it.
He didn't even transfer his Deso, too. That's the worst.
Arrow! Oh my goodness, Sing Sing. Spies out the 5-man top with that arrow. Doesn't hit. Doesn't matter. Alright, we're both brutally wrong because Eternal Heavy has decided to just solo this up practically. AUI is joining him for a fun, but he doesn't do any damage.
Yeah, they had like 4 middle, but then they decided, oh, we don't even need 4 people to do it. We'll just go find more on CM and Puck and just have Sing Sing.
Yeah, you gotta put those minuses to work.
Yeah.
Roshan has fallen to the Dire.
Maybe if you get enough minuses, maybe you just all click Midas on Roshan at once.
They just all need refreshers right now.
Crumbles into a tower of gold. Radiance is up on Miracle, though, and we're going to see the beginning of that split push. But once again, the Radiance is picked up, and it feels like Speed Gaming, they're already ready to fully commit to a bit more five-manning objective-based gaming.
Sing Sing's going to go Lincoln's for the glimpse. I really like that.
Here I am.
I really like that. I'm pretty sure he's going to do that just for that. That's going to help out a lot. Can you... If you put on a Lincoln's when they're being... No, never mind. Never mind. JK, answer my own question, guys.
All right, good job. Medic is going to be up on KYXY. That early Venomancer farm getting them so far. Ohio rotating up with the rest of the crew to see if they can pick off a support or something.
Here comes Bone 7 with the Eternal Envy. Bomb.
Oh god, he's got Dagger.
Oh yeah. Do they have sentries?
Initiating with the Invis.
Windrunner.
Oh, if they could just see this coming. They don't have much lockdown though. Oh, that silence! Oh, what a beautiful play! Bone 7, beautiful initiation. They're just going to clean up two heroes. Nice hookshot in order to get himself away. He's going to try and teleport. Will be able to do so. KYXY, he's going to fall though. Open wound's going to be up. Actually, KYXY knows he's dead. He turns to get as much damage out as possible. Forces some teleports back to base. But 3-0. Speed Gaming with a beautiful initiation coming out from Bone 7.
They didn't know they had the gem, so this courier just sniped the gem.
Oh,
that's one really? Good thing.
Hold on.
Yeah. And it's a regular donkey. Do we flame people for regular donkeys nowadays?
No, we don't.
No?
Okay. We admire them for their
courage.
We admire them for their
hard work and dedication from the beginning of Dota.
No, Titan had they did that last time versus DK too. They actually just had regular old donkey.
Donkey. I love Shrek. Nobody? All right, fine, be that way.
No.
Not a Shrek lover, dude? What's your problem, man?
No. Stop. Stop.
Alright.
Well, you're wrong, by the way.
I know. I was hoping for the Lincolns. Didn't happen.
Yeah, that definitely didn't happen. Manta is up on Sing Sing. So much for your predictions.
I know.
You tried to go too far. You just tried to go too far. You tried to predict too many things, and you got all wonky with your prediction. It went like, nah, not Manta. Clearly, it's going to be Lincolns versus the Glimpse.
I tried the
you tried to be too extreme.
Last game, too, for the Naga. Bet if he went that, they would have won, though. For sure, no.
By the way, this analysis is brought to you by the experts over at Pretty Boy Swag in there. Never mind.
Never mind.
I was going to make the same joke twice.
It's okay. Miracle's probably not dead.
Oh,
maybe
Miracle.
Dead.
Yeah. If he gets hit by the arrow, he's just trying to dodge the arrow and see if he can get it off. No, it still isn't enough. The Dagon is able to go down. I was thinking if he could just make sure he doesn't get hit by the arrow, maybe he had a chance. It wasn't even close. Dagon completely wiped him out. He's going to have another level two. He's got Dagon
and
3 about to pick
dead.
Up level 4.
Disruptor's dead.
Oh dear, Disruptor.
Three-shotted. And a blink dagger. He has a blink dagger, yeah.
They slowed him down, but what can they really do? Living armor plus a gigantic lifestealer. Arrow! Not going to be able to land in anything. Still though, they're just walking through towers. No problem. Bone 7 doesn't have his ultimate, but it doesn't matter. Ohio, nice bump out, and he's actually going to push Eternal Envy away. He's probably...
Bone 7's dead.
Yeah, he's definitely dead. Oh, there he goes. He falls. Eternal Envy was able to get out, save his Aegis.
And uses Midas. And oh, well, yeah. That's pretty
just
cool.
Just keeps going down, down, down. 23,000, 24,000.
What if they just invisibility. Get a Dagon 5 on CM2, and they just double Dagon 5 them?
What, so they can walk around one-shotting creeps with Midas and one-shotting heroes with Dagon?
Yeah.
They just like run around just picking up gold
game.
Left and right. That's the new meta. I don't want to live in this world.
Better than seeing Necro books all day.
No, I disagree. I like Necro book pushes.
Oh.
It gets
gosh.
Like the sustainability of like some of those push lineups. And you can actually push later. I find
then
Necro
makes,
book
then
gaming
it makes push lineups
exciting
even more balanced,
and
though.
Fun.
I agree that it balances it out when you don't have a push lineup, but when you do, it just makes it really imbalanced. It's like why they banned Venge Blink Dagger and Pudge Blink Dagger. I never understood the Pudge Blink Dagger ban. I understood the Venge, but
Radiant's bottom
that's just
tower
silly.
Is under
yeah,
attack.
Venge is funny. Ohio actually jumps in on Bone 7 easy. Still nice. Done. Yeah. Finally pick up something. 6-20, 27 minutes in. Meanwhile, Miracle. Farming up that jungle.
Uh-oh. AUI got scouted out. Sentry. I see him.
AUI maybe going to get caught out as well. Nice shackle shot. And they should be able to pick this one up, right? Great.
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for something to happen terrible. Nice push out. And with the cogs.
Windrunner kind of ran away, like she expected them to be just coming or something.
E-sama like, cometh.
Yeah.
And everybody runs away.
He doesn't want those, oh, never mind.
Maelstrom is up on Mirana right now. He didn't make that call earlier. Even if he
did make that call. I'm 1-1? 1-2?
There it goes.
1-2. I'll take 1-2.
Yeah, okay.
Alright.
I didn't bring
called the blink dagger on Nyx. Just kidding, I didn't call that.
Oh, blink dagger game in the turtle envy. You. It's
It's a really good item.
I'm trying to think the last time I saw this on Lifestealer. This isn't the first time.
At least 2-3 Radiant's patches middle ago where attack. People couldn't break the base. I think because it was like tinker picks and stuff or something. So people just have to like buy blink daggers and just blink in on the heroes.
Yeah, and what's more perfect than getting in melee range of a hero before you open wounds? Instantly blink on open wounds and nom 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 nom. Not like he doesn't have
enough. Bottom lane.
AY, you're dead, buddy. This gank squad of Titan is making small grounds. Dyer's small grounds, I don't think.
They might get a tower.
Yeah, Radiant's I don't know about that. They instantly back off. They're just too afraid. They're going to go top, see if they can grab some there. Pile I die, and Sing Singer pushing in right now. They are in this.
I think they just saw the, yeah, they saw the Mirana. How did they see him? Oh, yeah, I think it wore out, yeah.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
Manta is beginning to come up on Miracle. And there it is, the first of the Necro books.
No, that's the second. AUI's got two. No one. I thought he had enough for two.
Whatever, man. First of the Necro books.
They ain't the first of the Necro books. That's the second. CM has the second, and then AUI got the first one like 5 minutes ago.
Players here.
I'm just gonna ignore you and say, Agnes is gonna be up on Clockwork. I'm just getting so bored waiting for Speed Gaming just to like crush Titan. And that's what it really feels like with a 25,000 gold experience lead and about the same in gold. Like, I don't care how well Miracle does on his Naga Siren. This is already proved in game one.
Yeah, he's not going his patented Thinkins. We don't have a chance.
Yeah. And this is, like, even worse than last game. Like, in the last game, they started out the Radiance looking out okay, but Speed Gaming just kept on building more and more gold on top of that. Now, like, Speed Gaming already has the golden experience built.
Gather round.
Ooh. Wow. Bone Savage just doesn't know where to go.
He's yeah, like, he
which
didn't.
One is it? Dagging down creeps, no problem.
Turtle Envy's gonna 1v4.
Oh, yes he is. He's kind of surrounded on all sides. Runs into Wind Ranger, but there goes the Wind Run. Ohio waiting patiently to throw down the hookshot at the right time. Or Cogs. And they're gonna throw down the Silence. They may be able to pick this one up. Ohio in a little bit of trouble there. Wind Ranger gets popped. Can they just pick off Eternal Envy? In fact, he does. Cogs pushes him out and gets him killed.
Yeah. Eternal Envy would want that one back right there. The Cogs were all about to end, so he tried to kind of time it, but he got pushed out of the Cogs. You should have just stayed in and armlet toggled. Think.
Sing, sing. Yeah. Do it. Throw the arrow.
He'll do it. Throw it. He scouted though.
He's got that, like a sixth sense about that sort of thing.
Let's see, what's next for Sing Sing? Calling MKB.
Really, MKB? You're not gonna go real try hard and call out
Dagon
the,
5?
The Abyssal blade that no one is expecting?
No, he's gonna go F blade for the Dagon 5 puck.
Oh, okay, yeah, that's smart. So we can F blade, arrow, and then Dagon 5 comes in from puck.
Do you know how fun that is in pubs?
Yes. It's like you're Midasing heroes.
Yeah, yeah. You know the sad part is that AUI had his Necro book 5-6 minutes before the CM, and he's got Necro 2 before he does.
Yeah, and that's what I mean by first in Necros. He's obviously going to get Necro 3 before AUI.
Yeah, that's what you meant. I know what you meant.
I know. I know what I meant. I was about to say, again, Aghanim's almost up on Clockwork. derp, derp, derp. I already talked about that. Waiting for something to happen.
This disruptor needs a Midas. If he had a Midas, he'd have another
item. Pileidai pops his ultimate, but is instantly stopped by the ensnare. And Miracle is going to leave his illusions to Riptide. Oh! Bone 7 tried to. He tried to dag in and wipe out the illusions before they could Riptide and kill Pileidai. But nice try, but no cigar.
Yeah.
Another Roshan bites the dust. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
No, that's 7.3. No, you round up.
Up.
This is Price is Right. This is Price is Right.
Bone 7. They may be really, really far ahead, but that Dagon 5 does no favors for your survivability there, Bone 7. That's why Disruptor is a good mid-game support. Unfortunately, they just so far behind. He's going to jump inside Sing Sing, and they're going to give themselves a little bit of invis jump. And, oh, boy.
Dire's courier
teleports
has been
just in time. Uh-oh, and AUI is actually in a little bit of trouble as well. They're going to pick up a Dire Courier, a Dire Hero, two Dire Heroes because they picked up Puck. Man, what a comeback. They're doing it. I mean, kind of. The gold lead and inexperience lead is still dropping somehow. But they're doing it. They're doing it. Tier 1 tower picked up by Miracle.
They've acquired all the gems on the map, so they're clearly leading this.
You get enough gems, you unlock the secret chest inside the base.
Illusion.
There lies 5 Abyssal Blades. And one Rapier.
Sad part is that I don't think any of the heroes could even use the Abyssal Blade besides Clockwork, and I guess Windrunner could just Windrun up and Abyssal.
Ryu, did you ever do the Dota 1 secret quests in any of the 9
secret
quests? Yeah.
No.
You know, for Carl, the Invoker. No. You never fought Elder Titan. Okay. Whatever. Whatever, man. You've heard of this, right?
No, I haven't.
Oh God.
Is this recently or
no,
is this a long,
is,
long time
this
ago?
This has always been in Dota 1. Every single 9 version, there is something secret to reveal. There's a secret quest in order to reveal the new heroes. Right? So yeah. That's why I always hate Invoker, because I did the quest and he killed me. Disruptor gets picked up by the ganking duo.
They know Miracle's top lane.
Radiant's bottom tower is under attack.
Are they gonna get this pick? Run, Crystal Maid, run!
Oh, look at Miracle.
Look, they're so fast.
He's beginning to do it.
He's going for it. He's going for it.
Oh, Pileidai, can he get the ensnare just in time before the teleport's out? And he picks up Pileidai once again. He's dominating right now. And he is actually the head in net worth. How is this happening?
Puck
barely getting out.
Puck kill.
Speed game, you may need to end the game sometime soon. I'm just saying, Miracle's getting mute. They're almost back to 20,000 gold. Oh,
they got Abyssal on Nyx now. Playing really aggressive.
There goes the arrow. Necronomicon pushes. Glimpse back. Nope. There goes the rage. Ohio forced out himself away. He does not want to be within melee range of that Lifestealer. At all. Shack Shot fails to land here. Aegis is about to go down here. They're going to try and pop it. He keeps trying to use his Midas. Did he just do that? Sing Sing, did you just do that? They're going to start out Sing Sing. Eternal Envy being silenced right now. He's trying to get away. He has to infest inside a creep. No, he's just going to fight Clockwork. Turning it up. Meanwhile, Miracle's on the backside. He's cleaning up heroes left and right as well. Scaring the rest of the team away. Keeping them slept while the rest of the team finishes off Eternal Envy. Well done by Miracle. Holds the team in place. Catches out AUI. Picks up that kill. Sleeps. Holds the rest of Speed Gaming there while his team cleans up Eternal Envy. Man. How is Titan doing this? Unbelievable. Boots of Travel now picked up by Naga Siren.
Yeah, they're kind of getting lackadaisical.
Yeah, they kind of are. Am I just daydreaming, or did I see Sing Sing try and deny Eternal Envy on the Aegis?
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure I saw Eternal Envy start getting low, and he was about to go down and pop the Aegis, and Sing Sing went in for the deny. I'm pretty sure that happened.
They got two Necro 3s now for the bottom lane, and they have no glyph for a long time, 3 minutes or so. So that's why I think they're going to get this rack soon. I think they are. I think they got what it takes.
Come on, Speed Gaming. You think so? I don't know. Maybe they should farm up another 10,000 gold lead.
This null talisman, Talisman Evasion, is doing work. Doing work now.
Look at all the items. All
right, so I set an MKB on Murana.
Yeah,
kinda...
you're so good. How did you
no,
that
just
out?
Kidding. No, I just kind of have to. I assume Turnerinvy's going to pick one up too.
Top tower is under
unless
attack.
He goes like Caress, because he does need armor. But he's just getting kited around from the Vino.
My god, you know, Four Staff Gaming.
From where?
From all of Titan.
The opposite team.
Jesus.
Yeah. It's the reversal.
They know how to deal with the Lifestealer.
Whoever gets 4 staffs wins the game on the one team.
Well, that's a lie.
Dire's top tower is
it worked
attack.
Out last game.
Yeah, last time it was Speed Gaming.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Necrobooks.
They're gonna switch to fallen. Bottom lane. But
Ohio's plan is apparently to spam out every 10 seconds a hook and a blink away.
Top tower has
arrow. Ohio dodges it. Radiant's teleports are coming back in. They need to go soon. Attack. Eternal Envy, he's diving deep. Allies. But there goes the four staffs. He just can't seem to target anybody. Meanwhile, Miracle coming in on the backside, trying to do some work. Puck is already taken down. Miracle pops his ultimate. Meanwhile, Eternal Envy, he's already trapped in. He goes down. Disruptor. Being able to finish him off with the ultimate, now Pilot Eye is going to fall. What the hell is happening? They didn't even pick up a Rax. Miracle chasing AUI. Glimpse back. My god, it's just a stomp. What is happening? They pick up 4 heroes, lose nothing. Nothing. What is happening? Not a hero, not a building. What? 25,000 gold lead, and it's not enough.
They got a tier 2 mid.
They got a tier 2 mid. That wasn't a team fight, though. That was them just giving up tier 2 mid.
Yeah, that, true.
Oh, my goodness. Isama.
Dire's
just
bottom tower
not
is
enough
under
mercy
attack.
In the world.
Dire's structures are fortified.
I did this in an NEL game. I went Necrobook 3 on Nyx. People flame me, but I think it's actually really good against a Venomancer here. I think he needs it, or at least a Sage and Yasha right now. He needs mobility really badly.
Important to dealing with a Venomancer with mech and four staff. Ohio jumping in, jumps on Sing Sing.
No, it's just from the slow. Like Venomancer has too much slow right now, and it's really hurting. Eternal Envy, just kiting him.
Nice deny by Bone 7, and oh my goodness, like Titan's back in this game. I'm actually getting kind of hyped up now. Yeah, watch the next team fight just like completely fall apart for Titan. They go outside of their base and they just get crushed and lose the game instantly.
It's like, what
right
are they doing,
as
guys?
Right as I get into the game, we're like, yeah, let's do this, Titan. Let's do this. Comeback time.
Well, he's got 5,000 gold, so.
Yeah, he could sell his drums and start working towards his heart. Just saying.
They could get picked up here.
Uh-oh, there it goes. Eternal Envy, he's done for. That's the jump in. Ohio hits the hook shot. Cogs jumps out while the Static Storm keeps Lifestealer from being able to Rage, Infest, do anything good. That's why Disruptor's good. He's a great mid to late game support.
Though. Huh? So, hey, all is not lost.
Don't spoil my party. Oh, Ohio jumping in on Sing Sing, blinks away. My god, he needs to stop doing that. He's freaking me out. Now it's Titan's turn to push. Doing little bits of damage on tier 3. I don't know if they can really sit here, but maybe they can at least try and force out the buyback.
I believe in Sing Sing. He's got this game.
Yeah.
He's got it.
Isama may be offering mercy, but Sing Sing offers none.
I don't know, actually. A heart and butterfly Naga. This actually looks really scary. I actually kind of feel for Speed Gaming now. I don't know. It's still really close. I'm just going to look at the gold graph and see what it tells me. It tells me nothing.
Well, it tells you it's sneaking.
Tell me that's
like,
how
I,
much...
I can't believe I'm saying this in a professional game, but I'm like, all right, they're only down by 15,000 gold now.
Yeah, and he's got a heart. He's buying it too when he goes to the.
All right, there's nothing happening right now, and there, we got the recap of that this last team fight at bottom. Oh, it actually I caught the tail end. Sorry, I should have done it earlier. Should have done it earlier. I was too busy fiddling with the other mouse. This blink dagger's doing work though for Ohio. Again, hit Sing Sing and blinks away. Like, there's no point to it. Just no. You're on watch, Sing Sing. Ohio puts you on watch. That's your warning. How about you don't farm ancients ever again? Heart is now up on Miracle. Plus, he's got buyback ult. Look at that. They jumped into the Roche pit to see if they can sneak in a Roshan with Puck. Puck and the Infest duo. Jumping in. They're actually going to go in. Sing Sing gets caught out. Miracle is now godlike. He's going to pop his ultimate, wait for Cogs to go out, and they're actually going to catch this. Oh, God. Can they get it? They've got two inside the storm. Oh, Eternal Envy. He's going to fall. Next is going to be Bone 7. This is a disaster. Speed Gaming. Buyback coming in. Lifestealer. Can they really make the rest of this work? Miracle's getting low. Eternal Envy. He's coming back with his second life, but if he doesn't get this, Sing Sing's coming in as well. They will be able to lock down Miracle. So it does end up being a wipe for a wipe, and they're going to turn this into Roshan. So the buybacks do end up being worth it, but oh, my goodness. That was a really good setup. Miracle seeing the opportunity to catch two heroes out in very, very close proximity. Two really important heroes with his ultimate. Sleeping them in order to set up the static storm. That storm just is destroying lifesteal.
Roshan has fallen to the they need something to either pick off Disruptor or... Like, Force Staff, you can't Force Staff out of the Disruptor. So, I mean, it's a really nice setup for late game. It's one of the best setups. The only thing you can really do is get a BKB. And the counter to that is obviously Ags, but I don't think this Disruptor has enough to get an Ags. So they really need BKBs on, I would dare say, on Potom and Nyx.
All right, well, here comes the moment of truth for Titan. Can they finally make this comeback worth it? There's going to be no buybacks on Speed Gaming. The important heroes are down. Puck, Lifestealer, and Mirana don't have buybacks. They do have Aegis and Cheese.
Uh-oh.
Nice Shackle Shot. This is the beginning of something good. They could do some decent damage here. Bone 7, he instantly wipes out Disruptor. There's going to be no Static Storm this time. Eternal Envy, he pops a Cheese, keeping himself alive. Rax, gonna fall soon. Buyback coming out from the Naga Siren. He's gonna go forward, see if he can catch anything. He's got Pylai die. Unfortunately, his creeps just keep on running forward. They're gonna pick off one hero, and that's gonna be it. Eventually? No, no one's there. Okay, very well. Let's him go.
They wanna go back in. It's down.
Yeah, Rax is about to go down. Eternal Emmy, he's gonna clean that one up. He's gonna keep going forward. Gonna try and pick off KYXY. Force Staff, though, keeping them at bay. They're going to go ahead and pick up the range back.
Bone 7's trying really hard to pick up this Disruptor again.
Oh, bottom. They actually pick up Sing Sing. Sing Sing is going to lose his Aegis here due to the poison. They don't lose anything for it. They successfully forced death themselves away. And can they get Sing Sing here? There goes the Sleep Static Storm. They're going to be able to pick him up. That is a dead, dead Sing Sing. Still, maybe. Poison actually still going up. Pilot Eye being sent back. Poison could be able to wipe him out. Ohio blinking forward. He has the position. Can he get some cogs off? 5 seconds still. Eternal Envy trapped in the Titan Snare. Fighting Illusions. He goes down for it. Aegis. Cheese. Buybacks. It's all down. Pilot dies. The last hero left for Speed Gaming. And Titan, they're on the hunt. Drawing down, straight down middle. They're going to try and even up the racks and see what they can get here. And they've got 90 seconds until Lifestealer's back up. My God, have they done it? Are they going to actually be able to turn this around and be ahead after taking two racks? Look at that gold lead. It's still 20,000 in the favor of Speed Gaming. Inexperience as well. It doesn't matter. Miracle is huge. He's going to clean through this tower. They still got another 40 seconds until Sing Sing's up. And even that is not going to disrupt their push. Can they go all the way? Do they have the time? There's no Glyph now. Glyph is down. Do they go all the way for Rax here? Oh no, they're going to go for it. Oh, don't tease me like that. There it is. They're going to go for the Rax. They've got the time. They think they can do it in 30 seconds till Mirana's up. This should be GG. Titan. They've managed to make the comeback. If they could just finish off this last couple of buildings, AY is going to try and disrupt them as much as he can, but he instantly falls. Buys back. He's going to come in again with Overgrowth. See if he can stop him, Ohio. He's keeping him at bay. Hook shots back. They're going to start going for the other tier 4. He's about to fall. Throne's going to be next on the target. Sync things up in 5 seconds, but I don't think it's going to matter. No glyph to save anything. Half health. There goes the ult. Overgrowth stopping him a little bit. There goes the damage some more. Ohio, he's just trying to keep Sync Sync in place. He's trying to make him a non-factor. Puck is now up. He's going to come into team fight, but it doesn't matter. It's over. Miracle calls GG. And Titan come back from the most amazing gold lead. Oh my god. God, 48 minutes in, 30-28. Once upon a time, there was a 25,000, over 25,000 gold lead and experience lead on Speed Gaming, and they just managed to throw it all the way, and we are going to a game 3, baby. My God, Titan, how did they pull that off?
It's like the combo that I said, that if they can get it to the late game, it's really one of the best. You have the Naga Siren sleep initiation into the Disruptor ulti, and also they use a lot of the clockwork hooks into Disruptor ultis, and because you don't even have to put down the force field, you could just clockwork hook in ulti, and then the cogs count as your kinetic field, and that basically got like 4 or 5 pickoffs towards the 40 minute and onward game, which basically allowed them to push down the lanes, the map control.
All right, guys, we're going to take a short little break. I'm going to try and play an ad. I forgot last time. Try and play some ads. Don't go anywhere, though. We will be right back with Game 3, Speed Gaming versus Titan.